السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. To all panels and postgraduate coordinator, today I would like to present my PhD progress report, semester 6, 2024-2025. Okay, my name is Nuriana Mithu Bahari. So my proposed title is Optimal Electric Bus Charging Coordination Strategy Using Hybrid Artificial Intelligence with Demand Side Management for Campus Facility under Enhanced Time of Use Tariff. My main supervisor is Professor IR Dr. Nofriani Dahlan from UiTM, and my co-supervisor is PS Dr. Muhammad Faniston from UTEP. Okay. So, from where it starts is the background of the research. Okay, first point is air pollution. Okay, the contribution of the air pollution from transportation sector is 14.8%. So, one of the transportation sector is bus. Okay, bus such as it was widely used in many places such as school bus, shuttle bus, tourist bus, express bus, and many more. And currently, there are electric bus using in campus. Okay, so number two is the government encouragement. So in Malaysia, we have NAP Malaysia 2020, which is this policy. Malaysia to build EV smart grid. Okay, which is the interoperability center. And also to employ the well-to-wheel model in the computation of emission EB. Okay, the last one is the trend on the adoption of the electric bus in campus. Okay, to have a sustainability campus transportation system. Like in Malaysia, we have a campus university that use electric bus as the campus transportation, like UTM. Okay. So this is my problem statement and also the objective. Yeah, problem statement one is when we have the electric bus, we want to charge the bus, which is usually we will charge the bus from electricity taken from the grid. Okay, so from this, it will increase the energy demand and contribute a high peak load. Okay, therefore we need to have a proper EV charging coordination. Okay, at the campus building. By considering the battery size selection and also the electric bus charging scheduling. Okay, so this problem established the objective number one, okay, which is to develop the electric bus charging schedule for campus facility using fuzzy logic algorithm, considering the Mamdani type fuzzy inference system. Okay, so the next problem statement is problem number two. Okay, which is the lack of study using FL-PSO algorithm, the hybrid, okay, to optimize the EV charging schedule in campus facility. So there are numerous number of research focusing on the optimization of the electric bus schedule. But using other method, okay, like meta-heuristic optimization like VNS, and also many of them using mathematical application optimization. Problem three, the limitation on the related research areas to consider simultaneous the EV charging load management strategies with meta heuristic optimization algorithm for ETAU type scheme. Okay. So these two problems is combined to have the objective number two, to formulate and optimize the electric bus charging schedule for campus facility to minimize energy cost and maximum demand. Using FL-PSO algorithm considering ETAU tariff. Okay, the next one is the problem statement number four. So in Malaysia, there are no implementation of a specific tariff scheme. Okay, especially for the special load like electric vehicle or electric transportation charging load, especially in campus building or commercial building or industrial building. So it is important to analyze the existing tariff suitable for the electric bus charging load or not. Okay, especially in campus facility. So we will focus on two tariff, OPTR and ETAU tariff. Okay, from this problem statement number three and four, the objective three is established. Objective 3 is to enhance the optimization of electric bus charging schedule for campus facility by integrating load management strategies using FLSO algorithm, considering ETAL and also OTR tariff. So this the problem statement BS versus objective map. So this is the early or hypothesis for my research. Okay, so I will do two types of mainly two types of analysis. The first one is load profile, and the second one is cost analysis. Okay. So this is the load profile analysis. As we can see on the left is the unoptimized load profile. Okay, when we apply the electric bus, when we add the electric bus charging load to the existing building load, we can see that the orange one is the building load plus the charging load. Okay, we can see there is a spike during the peak hour and also mid-peak hour. Okay, additional load to the peak hour and mid-peak hour. Okay, so this is what we have now. So what we want, okay, what we want is we want to shift the peak and transfer it to the off-peak time zone. Okay, if we can see, the green one is the optimized load profile. Okay, so there is no more spike during the peak and also mid-peak hours. Okay, basically, this is what we want to achieve. Okay, for the cost analysis, okay, basically, I will use three type of tariff: flat price, okay, the ETAL tariff, and also OPTR tariff. Okay, so this is the comparison. You want to see the decrease or increase of the electricity cost. For the research purpose, this is the objective one checklist. Okay, so objective one, I will develop the electric bus charging schedule for campus facility using fuzzy logic algorithm, considering the Mamdani type. Okay, why I want to develop electric bus charging schedule? Because I will use UTEM as my case study. Okay. So currently we don't have any electric bus using in around the campus, but we have the conventional bus service schedule. Okay, so from this existing service bus information or schedule, I will transform it into the electric bus charging schedule. Okay, so starting with the bus information, okay, number of buses, the number of trip. Okay, we have the charging, we have the service schedule. Okay, I will come up with the routing process to create the 8 routes. Okay, to gain the kilometers or miles to mileage of the each bus for 5 days. Okay, and then from that, I will select the electric bus, the model of the electric bus, and also the charging equipment. Okay. Next is the data preparation and calculation for the input fuzzy logic, including the normalization of the data. Okay. So, the next one is the fuzzy logic algorithm. Okay, coding. Also the coding. I use the MATLAB, and then the defuzzification, the output, extraction. And the output will be the service schedule and also priority schedule. So this objective one, I can say that I finished 100% lah. Okay, next one is the objective two checklist. The objective two is to formulate an optimal electric bus charging schedule for campus facility to minimize energy cost and maximum demand using fuzzy logic PSO, FLPSO algorithm, considering ETAL. Okay, so this is the checklist. The first one is the PSO coding. Yeah, I use the use Python, and then PSO input. PSO input for my coding is the building load consumption. Okay, the priority schedule. Okay, start time and time, priority, And also the charging duration. This is the result from the objective one. And then the data collection, service schedule, variety schedule with PSO and booking PSO method. Okay. Case study, I have 4 plus 8 case study. 4 is for the load profile, 8 for the cost analysis. So this one I use, I will do the comparison ETAU or PTR. Okay. And the data analysis on the load profile is also done. So for objective 2, I will do the data analysis cost analysis. I will do the analysis for the cost analysis. Okay. So this is the case studies, okay, for load profile analysis. Case one, the load profile is for building and optimized priority and optimized priority PSO. Case two, building and optimized priority booking PSO, and also case three, building plus optimized service PSO. Case four, building and optimized service and optimized service booking PSO. Later, I will explain the definition of the priority service PSO and also booking PSO. Okay, so this is the case study for the load profile analysis. And then this is the case study for the cost analysis. So there will be eight. Okay, the derivation from case one will be case one A and one B. From case two, there will be case two A to B. For case 3, TA, TB, and case 4, for A, for B. So the difference is only I will apply the ETAU and OPTR. This is the objective checklist for objective 3. So basically, the PSO coding is already done, which is I integrate the load management, which is load shifting. The input setting, I will use the load consumption. This one is from objective 2 and also the tariff. So the data collection, I managed to do it 20%, and the case study has been set up. Okay, the case study will be case one is the building only. Okay, we want to see if we apply the load shifting, what happened to the building load profile. And the case two, I will apply the unoptimized priority load profile. And then next is optimized priority PSO, optimized priority booking PSO. Case five, unoptimized service. Case six, optimized service PSO. And lastly, the optimized service booking PSO. Okay, so the difference between objective two and three is objective two, we don't have load management strategies. Objective three, we have the load management strategies. Okay. So this is the important definition. Okay. Important definition for the terms that I've been talking about. Okay. Service schedule. What is service schedule? Service schedule is the original or existing campus bus service schedule. Okay. So this service schedule referring to the electric bus charging schedule. Okay. So the start time of the charging were taken after the last service of each buses. Okay. So for the priority schedule is the electric bus charging schedule that has been improved from service schedule using fuzzy logic algorithm. Okay, now the charging time is arranged by the priority based on their SOC level and the charging duration. For the PSO method, it is an ordinary PSO method. So the start charging time for each BEB was refined by the lowest charging cost. For booking PSO method, still using PSO method, but it was modified, where the start charging time for each BEB was defined by the nearest availability time and the lowest cost. So this is the result for objective one. Okay, if you can see the service schedule, okay, on the top is the first one arrive, and is arranged by the first one arrive and the SOC level. Okay, so the next one is priority schedule is based on the FL algorithm. Okay, basically, the result is neglecting the SOC level, but The accuracy level is one of the input for the FL. Okay. So the difference between these two is, if we can see on Tuesday, Thursday, and Friday, the start charging time for each buses is different. Okay. So this is the objective to resolve. Okay. So this is the case one. Okay, the comparison of the load profile for 1 week, Monday to Friday, for building load, for unoptimized priority, and also using optimized space. Oh. Okay, if you can see, the green one is the spike or load peak created by the electric bus charging load. Okay, and then when I apply the optimized space, oh, the load now is shaped and shifted to the off-peak zone, okay? So basically, it's the same. Okay. This one is for the priority schedule using booking PSO. And this one is for the service schedule, okay? This one, we optimize the service schedule. Basically, the spike will be moved to the off peak time zone. This one using booking PSO. So what one want to see is the also the cost analysis. Okay. So this load shifting, building load. Okay, for objective three. So for load shifting, I've set a few percentage to see the difference. Okay, this is the load profile for 5%. Okay, the blue one is the baseline. The yellow one is the shift one. Okay, so same applied to 20%, 50%, and also 80%. Okay, you can see that the load is shifting. Okay, so should be for objective 2 and 3, I will include the cost analysis. Okay. Okay, next is the progress on the publication. So the three publication is, the first one is conference paper ICET. The title is Price Elasticity in the TOU Tariff for PEV Home Charging Emulation Case Study. The second one is overview on the electric bus charging schedule, a case study of battery electric bus as campus transportation in UTEM. Number three is evaluation of time of use tariff responsiveness for PEV home charging in Malaysia. Okay, so next publication I plan to publish in Sustainable Energy Technologies and Assessment Journal, and also Energy and Building Journal. So this is my thesis writing progress. So chapter 1 introduction 80%, chapter 2 judicial review 70%, chapter 3 objective 1 10%, chapter 4 objective 2 10%, chapter 5 objective 3 10%, and also chapter 6 conclusion 0%. Okay, I will reach conclusion later. Okay, so I will have 6 chapter all for my thesis. For next semester planning, I will do more on the data analysis. I will try to finish the data analysis. This is writing, also publication writing for 1 or 2 publication. So that's all for me. Thank you for your attention. Okay, so thank you for your attention.